I've been so impressed by the work that Rachel and the entire NDP caucus have done, you know, on behalf of Albertans. And I'm feeling more and more excited about Election Day in 2023 and restoring, you know, an NDP government to Alberta and putting people first again in this province.
We are working with all Albertans to build Alberta's future.
Let's provide real support to workers and their businesses, especially during this pandemic.
We need universal, affordable, accessible, and quality early learning and childcare in Alberta.
Let's support workers. Let's create new jobs that are quality workplaces, safe workplaces.
Let's make sure that Alberta's she-covery is big and bold.
Let's recognize post-secondary education for what it is, an economic engine for the growth of our economy.
Let's make Alberta the leading developer of renewable energy in all of North America.
Let's build an ambitious and forward-looking plan to rebuild downtown Calgary and revitalize it.
We are focused on supporting economic diversification, job creation, and new areas where we can grow.
Our greatest resource in this province is our people. It is their intelligence and their training and their ability to build a future that will encompass us all and that will move us forward.
It is vital that we protect public services and make sure that they are there to support the private sector. And when investors start looking at Alberta, they're gonna find a place that's incredibly modern, incredibly well-educated, with incredible health services.
The future of Alberta's economy is gonna be so dependent on small and medium-sized employers. It's gonna be dependent on us creating a culture to think about the future, whether that's climate, whether that's childcare. I think they may not seem like they're typical places for business to step in, but I think more importantly, as we have a very young demographic, a very young population, those issues are going to be at the forefront of what we need in this economy.
There's an opportunity to diversify our energy, to really move Alberta towards an energy province where we're not only conventional oil and gas, but, you know, we have new industries that use the same skills and technologies, but that can continue to diversify our economy. A lot of those people that are working in oil and gas are going to be the great minds that help renewables advance and all sorts of industries in advance. So they're critical for doing what we need to do now, as well as sort of helping us to invest into the technologies for the future.
As we look at diversifying our economy in the future, that culture of talent development is going to be extremely, extremely important.
Alberta has a positive future in front of us. We just need to be willing to reach forward and grasp it instead of reaching to the past. There is incredible opportunity in this province to create a future that will include us all.
I'm really optimistic that we have a bright energy future, and it's up to us to sort of start moving in that direction forward as opposed to looking backward.
Again, that's what the NDP wants to do. They want to make sure that all our public services are strong, that the people who deliver them are respected and have the tools they need to deliver them, and also that these public services are there to support the economy as a whole and make sure that the private sector has the infrastructure that it needs and these services for the people they employ. And that's how you have a strong economy.
I've got two young boys. I've got a three-year-old and a three-month-old. And forever, their passports are going to say the place they were born was Calgary in Alberta. And for me, it's the commitment that I need to make for them, that it doesn't just become something that they fill out when they're going to another airport. It needs to be home for them. I need to make Calgary, I need to make Alberta a better place than I was left it.
I really am hopeful that the job creation and the opportunity opportunities will be made available to Albertans so that they can stay here in the province that they love and continue to work on the things that they love to do.
And I believe once Rachel gets back into office, we're going to see economic growth that's going to be the envy not only of Canada but the world.